Hello everyone. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate two ways to check your Mac's internal and external SSD health. I will also answer the question of how often you should check your internal or external SSD's health and whether you need a third-party app to monitor their status. Let's get started. In macOS Sonoma or Ventura, go to the Apple menu and click About This Mac. Next, click More Info. Scroll down and click System Report. After that, click the Storage in the sidebar and check the Smart Status. If the result is verified, your SSD is functioning correctly. If it shows failing or fatal, there is an issue with your drive and you should backup your important files immediately. If you come across a message saying failed, it means that the drive cannot be used and is no longer functional. Next, I will connect my external SSD to my MacBook. I click on the Apple icon, then click About This Mac and click More Info and System Report. This time I click USB in the left sidebar and check the Smart Status for my external device. As before, I will see if it's verified, failing, or failed. Luckily, it is verified. I will now show you the second method to check the health of your Mac's SSD or hard disk drive. Click the Spotlight search icon and enter Disk Utility and click its name to launch it. In the Disk Utility window, click the View icon and select Show All Devices. Next, select your internal or external drive. Let's begin with the internal one. In my case, the internal disk shows no issues and is verified. I will now select my Samsung external SSD, but Disk Utility does not display any information regarding the health of my external SSD because it is not supported. However, I can use a different way to see if the SSD is healthy. With your external disk selected, click the First Aid icon. Click the Run button and wait for a few seconds. The operation is successful. If there is a repairable issue with your disk, Disk Utility will attempt to fix it for you. If Disk Utility cannot repair your disk, or if you receive a report that the first aid process has failed, you should try to repair the disk or partition once more. If this subsequent attempt fails, immediately backup as much of your data as possible. Reformat the disk, reinstall macOS, and then restore your backed up data. If you continue to experience issues with your disk and it cannot be repaired, it may be physically damaged and require replacement. You may want to know how often you should check your SSD or hard disk drive's health and whether you should install a third-party app to monitor your disk's health. If you frequently use your computer for intensive activities such as gaming, demanding applications, or video editing, in that case, it's a good idea to check your SSD's health every 1 or 2 months. However, The most effective way to prevent data loss is by backing up your important files daily or weekly in at least two locations. This could be on a USB flash drive, a cloud service, or two external drives. If you want more precise information about your SSD's condition, you can install a third-party app to provide such information. I installed one of these apps, but then I uninstalled it to save memory and battery life. As long as you have a backup of your files on an external device, there is no need to be much concerned about potential SSD or hard disk drive failure. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.